And welcome back to the Digital Education Station, everyone. We are thrilled to be here at Santa Anita Park with the 2019 Valedictorian of Arcadia High School, Kevin Tan.
Hello.
Kevin, this is such an honor to have you here. Congratulations on the honor being bestowed valedictorian of such an amazing class of Apaches. What was your first thought when you found out that you were going to be valedictorian of Arcadia High School this year?
Wow, you know, it's such a big honor, and honestly, in that moment, I was just in shock, you know. It's something that you really can't expect for in life, you know, and just seeing my name up there on the big screens, it's definitely huge, and I'm really honored to, you know, be able to have this position, I guess.
So what does it take? Everyone always wonders, like, there's so many great students at Arcadia High School. Academically, they're in sports, clubs, activities, music, performing arts. There's so much to do. Why do you think you, out of all the students, got selected for this? Kind of give us a little background, I guess, about your background and your experiences at Arcadia High School.
Yeah, so, you know, to become a valedictorian, I think you really do need, you know, a combination of a bunch of different things, right? Academics, extracurriculars, and I think that, you know, I've definitely exemplified a lot on the extracurricular side of, you know, that resume. I've been involved with a lot of campus organizations, things like Biology Olympiad Club, Chemistry Club, Leo Club, and, you know, I'm also part of a bunch of academic teams as well because, you know, I'm really interested in sciences and just academic competitions in general. So, you know, over the course of the 4 years I've had in Arcadia High School, I've joined quite a lot of academic teams. Just to name a few, like Academic Decathlon, Science Bowl, Science Olympiad, Constitution Team. It's just, it's a lot. And I guess, you know, beyond just having things on that resume, beyond just, you know, becoming a part of these clubs and organizations, I really think it's the passion that shines through and really, you know, differentiates you from the other people because, you know, through all these clubs and organizations, I've been able to pursue interests that I've had for a long time. And all the amazing people that I've met, they really drive me forward toward, you know, making the team better, making the clubs better. And I think that every single moment that I spent with these organizations, I'm happy. So, in that aspect, I really think that, you know, passion and showing that commitment is what, you know, really makes me stand out.
So everyone watching this, whether they're a student or a parent, they're wondering, how in the world do you balance all that? You've gotten actually straight A's all the way through middle school, through high school. I think we did the math. It's 88 straight A's, 6th grade through 12th grade. But you're also in all these clubs, activities, and the balancing act that you got to do. What advice would you give to somebody that has those passions, wants to pursue it, but you want to have balance, you don't want to be too stressed out, you need to get your sleep? How did you do it, and what advice would you give to fellow students?
Wow, so it's definitely a lot of time management. Time management is so crucial when you have just so many things to do. And I really think that finding that balance comes first from academics because, you know, throughout my high school years, I've taken classes that I was interested in. I know a lot of students tend to take AP classes or honors classes that they feel will, I guess, look good on a resume, but they aren't really interested in. And I feel like that's that first detriment that they have. You know, you really should take classes that you're interested in because if you're, you know, if you're not interested, you're just going to be bored in class. You're going to have no motivation. And, you know, but if you do find that, you know, that little aspect of that class you're really passionate about, I feel that your inner self will drive itself forward to, you know, achieving and doing well in those classes. And, you know, with time management, it's definitely a lot. It takes a lot of micromanagement with, you know, your after-school schedule, your, you know, weekend schedules, and really making sure that everything gets the right amount of priority, you know, on your list. And there's just so many little things that you have to do to make sure that you're on track, you know, setting little goals and long-term goals to make sure that, you know, you're kind of on the right pace and the right track. I feel like that's really crucial to making sure that, you know, you're just good at managing things, I guess.
So you're going to Harvard next year, studying biochemistry, one of your passions. Talk about the decision to go to Harvard and other options that you were considering, and why? I mean, obviously we know why Harvard, but tell us about your decision process for going to college.
Of course. You know, the college process for me, it's definitely been like a roller coaster. In terms of like my application process, it really kind of took a broad range of colleges that would really suit my passions. One of the criteria that I definitely found was, you know, do they have a research department? I'm really passionate about research and biochemistry, so I wanted to make sure that the colleges that, you know, I applied to also, you know, kind of mirrored those same influences. And, you know, I also wanted to continue a lot of the same clubs and teams that I'm still on, you know, in high school. So I wanted to make sure that, you know, the extracurricular life and academic life at those schools would also be, you know, kind of, you know, in consideration as well. Choosing a college after all those acceptances, definitely very difficult. You know, they're all super great institutions and they all have their individual merits. And, you know, but the thing that really stood out for me was, you know, things like geographic location, right? Boston, absolutely amazing culture there. And it's, you know, nice to, you know, go from West Coast to East Coast for a little while. You know, a lot of other things like undergraduate support, you know, the quality of the faculty. There's so many little things about Harvard that, you know, gave it the edge, I guess, in terms of selection.
Speaking of quality of faculty and staff, so many amazing teachers here in Arcadia Unified, the entire district, the high school, everywhere. Do you have a few teachers that kind of influenced you and kind of drove your passions and that really made a mark for you?
Yeah. Oh God, there's so many. I feel that every single teacher has made such a positive influence on me. But, you know, my AP Biology teacher, Mr. Mondin, I'd like to give a huge thanks to him because he really did drive that, you know, initial spark that really made me realize that biochemistry was this amazing subject. And I just remember spending sophomore year, you know, after school labs and just spending time with friends and learning new things. It was really a great experience. So many other of my science teachers also, Ms. Goto, Mr. Iguez, they've inspired me to continue, you know, my passion in sciences. And I also like to give a shout out to Ms. Leahy for being just a super kind person and being super supportive of us, both in Gov and, you know, outside, just in life in general. So, but yeah, every single teacher at Arcadia, really great positive influences.
There's kind of this misperception out there that in order to get to a school like Harvard, and a lot of your colleagues are going to Ivy Leagues, we have kids going to Stanford, MIT, Caltech again this year. Right now we have Arcadia High School alumni at every Ivy League school in the country, but there's this misconception out there that public education is kind of broken. You need to go to a private school to get to Harvard. What was your experience like going through a public school district like Arcadia, starting in elementary school, middle school, and now you're off to Harvard? Can you speak to kind of that misperception that not everyone understands that, you know, there's great public education systems out there and you're proof of that once again?
Yeah, you know, the whole thing about public education being bad, I feel like that's, you know, definitely a misconception. There's so many great opportunities that, you know, a public school like Arcadia is able to offer, and you really just have to drive yourself to find those, you know. One of the great things about Arcadia is that it's such a big school. There's so many awesome individuals that surround you every single day, each one of them, you know, driven to pursue their own passions. And I think that diversity really makes Arcadia special because, you know, there aren't that many high schools out there where you're able to meet so many like passionate people who are also, you know, dedicated to the same things that you are. So I think that, you know, with something as amazing as Arcadia, you're really given those resources to definitely excel. And, you know, from all the friends, all the faculty at Arcadia, they really do make the high school experience truly magical.
What will your message be tonight? You get the big speech, the valedictorian speech, all eyes on you. What is your message in that speech that you're going to give to everyone in attendance here at Santa Anita tonight?
You know, I think my message centers a lot around, you know, individuality and kind of self-perception. I think that, you know, high school really is this kind of game-changing moment for a lot of teenagers out there. And I think it's really important to realize how much we've grown, how much we still have yet to grow in the coming years. So I just wanted to give that message out there to make sure that everyone is just kind of, you know, comfortable with themselves and also open to, you know, opening their minds to the possibilities of change that are out there in the world.
Speaking of possibilities of change, last question for you. What change, what impact do you want to make on this world? I mean, the world is your oyster, as they say, and you have this great life and path ahead of you. Where do you see yourself 10, 15 years, and what impact do you want to have on when it's all said and done?
Yeah, you know, there's just so many things out there in the world that, you know, I want to change. And, you know, as someone pursuing biochemistry and research, I think that, you know, I'll be able to take those scientific innovations and really bring them out there into the public sphere. I know that, especially right now, science is a little bit de-emphasized within society, especially with the prevalence of social media, false information. And I really think that being able to take that kind of rationalization and critical thinking skills and applying it to the world will really help make the world a better place, you know, making it more open and more accessible to everyone.
Well, Kevin, on behalf of Dr. Van Alstel, our superintendent, our board of education, we are just so thrilled that you're representing Arcadia High School and Arcadia Unified as a valedictorian and going off to Harvard and doing these great things. You've been such an amazing student. All the teachers and staff we talked to, I know Ms. Leahy, she said, just raved about you and other teachers I spoke with. So we appreciate everything you've done for the district and will continue to do. And so just congratulations on everything. As the saying goes, once an Apache, always an Apache.
For sure.
And congratulations again. And we look forward to everything tonight.
Yeah.
Kevin Tan, thank you very much.
Thank you.